as soon as you start adjusting to your condition, and you lose another function and you have to adjust again. And it's never ending, it keeps going on and on and on and on.
Really simple things like getting dressed, combing your hair, brushing your teeth, shaving, you know, the little things that you don't notice.
Sometimes it becomes very frustrating when you have a little itch on your head. There's nobody around to itch it. Or when you have to go to the bathroom and you have to wait a couple of hours to 3 hours for somebody to come around to help you go to the bathroom. That's just unfair.
HIBM, Hereditary Inclusion Body Myopathy, is a very rare, debilitating and progressive muscle condition.
After 15 or 20 years or so, majority of patients that have HIBM are on a wheelchair or possibly worse. There are some HIBM patients that are completely bedridden.
It inhibits a lot of things you can do on a day-to-day basis. There are certain things that I used to be able to do with no problem, and now I just can't do those things anymore.
I'm still young and I have my whole life ahead. The most simple things and just the simple moments of life have suddenly become so difficult.
I noticed very gradually that my fingers were getting weak. And little by little, more and more opening jars and whatnot started to seem more difficult.
Year after year, we were getting weaker and weaker and weaker. And then at that point, we knew something really wrong was happening.
It was a rough journey. It was, you know, no definite answers at first. We started with some tests and definitely identified things that were not right. You know, the muscles were not normal.
With this disease, we didn't know. We would have 2 years, 5 years, 10 years.
Sought some answers in the library and flipping through literature, medical literature, trying to find out what's going on, and essentially self-diagnosed.
One of the discussions we had early on is that both me and Bobby are physicians, and we were both in the top 10% of our class in medical school, and we both have this disease, and we thought one of the best things we can do with our lives is to tackle this disease, and maybe it's our calling.
You have two options. You can either get in the game and, you know, affect the research yourself, or be on the sidelines and see what happens.
And we realized that because it's such an unknown disease, the first thing we need to do is make people more aware of it. The first meeting was in this house right here. A few of our friends and family members, about 10 or 15 people.
It was really the beginning of the organization, and came up with the name ARM. It stands for Advancement of Research Myopathies.
It was very clear that we're pretty well suited to tackle this problem.
You know, Danny had the idea of starting up his own lab. When I discussed with my colleagues who are in research and in clinical world, they're amazed at how much we've gotten done. You know, we've had a major breakthrough, major milestone pretty much every year since we started.
And one of the first things we did, we funded the effort for gene hunting to discover exactly what gene it is that causes HIBM. And we developed the first mouse model for HIBM. By doing so, we've sped up the development of a treatment at least by 10 years or more.
Also, the laboratory developed a very elegant study for carrier testing and patient testing. It was much faster than anything else at that time. There was no need for a blood draw. You could basically just do it with a cheek swab.
We've got one treatment that's being tested in people already. Second treatment is going to start testing fairly soon. And not in the too distant future, we're going to see gene therapy and possibly cell therapy being tested on human patients.
My passion is really to bring things that are going to be used in the clinic right away. And that's why I have a passion for this project, because it's something, to my knowledge, visible and doable.
I think ARM has done a really good job of putting together a community of patients.
All of them have really helped me to reach where I am today.
To see that you've done something positive, not just for yourself, for a lot of other people in the community. I don't think there is anything more gratifying than that.
It's no longer about finding the treatment, it's about funding the treatment.
The discovery is behind us. The basic science is behind us.
The one most critical factor with the research is more awareness and more funding. And the more of that we have, the faster we can move forward.
There will be treatment for HIBM in my lifetime. And I can say that with absolute confidence.